stem and roots, and cell derived from the primary meristem differentiated into permanent tissue. This meristematic tissue, they divide further on and they form the permanent tissue. Next, move on to the lateral meristem. So this apical meristem, it is present on the shoot tip and root tip. Next, we move on to the lateral side of the stem, that is the lateral meristem. This, as you can see, it is going from top to the bottom. It is present on the lateral side of the plant and along the sides of the central axis of the plant, and it gives rise to vascular tissues. Vascular tissue is the xylem and phloem, which conducts the water and nutrients from soil to the aerial part of the plant, and it also conducts or translocates the food from the leaf of photosynthetic portion to the other parts of the plant. So these tissues, they combine together to make the vascular tissue. So vascular tissue is formed by the lateral meristem, and this lateral meristem, it gives the annual rings in the terms of the tree. In the tree, whenever you have seen a tree, then you can find, if for example, if this is a tree, cut tree portion, then you will find the annual ring like structure here. This ring like structure, it is added on every year, and by counting this ring, you can tell the age of the tree. So this is formed by the lateral meristematic tissue, and these vascular tissue are formed to transport the food and water and minerals every year. These appears as rings, and these rings of small and large vessels which are added on each year causes growth in the thickness of the stem. Because this tissue forms everywhere, that's why the thickness of the stem increases by the division in the these tissues, in the vascular tissues. And on the basis of this, it is divided into two parts, that is the interfascicular cambium and core cambium. Interfascicular cambium presenting the vascular bundle, and core cambium, it is found underneath the bark of the tree, are examples of the lateral meristem. And lateral meristem